and are not allowed to leave the barracks for no reason whatsoever until further notice.
Can't do that.
It's against the Geneva Prisoner of War Convention.
And the rules of organized warfare.
And don't forget the Interstate Commerce Commission.
Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. This is lesson number 14 for the computer literacy course. We'll be covering Google Slides. In fact, this is the second part of the slides. At any time in the video, please click on thumbs up or like and share the video. Now, this is part two of the using Google Slides. So I'll be going over and actually doing a presentation on Hogan's Heroes, and then I'll take you step by step on what I did to create that presentation. So let's get started with that presentation. The presentation of Hogan's Heroes, presented by Daniel Barry. The agenda. Today we're going to be talking about the story, the characters, the TV show, the episodes. We'll have some student reviews and look at the student poll. The story. Set in a German prisoner of war POW camp, Luftstalag 13, during World War II, near the town of Hammelburg in the Bad Kissingen Woods. Stalag 13, which was on the Hammelburg Road, now known as the E-45, on the way to Hofburgstrasse and eventually to Dusseldorf, was the perfect staging point for the Allies to stage espionage on the Third Reich. The crew, led by the quick-witted American Colonel Robert Bob E. Hogan, sabotaged major Nazi operations, fed intelligence to the Allied command in Britain, offered aid to the resistance, and did their best to make their captors' lives incrementally more annoying day by day. The fictional Allied group's highest-ranking officer was Colonel Hogan, who always found a way to solve ever more complicated problems with the help of his staff of military experts. This wonderful crew was made up of two Americans, one British serviceman, and one Frenchman. They are able to accomplish schemes such as having a prisoner visit the camp as a phony Adolf Hitler or rescuing a French underground agent from the Gestapo headquarters in Paris. The characters: Commandant Klink, Sergeant Schultz, Fräulein Hilga, Colonel Hogan, Sergeant Carter, Staff Sergeant Kinch, Corporal Newkirk, and Corporal LeBeau. The TV show. The production of the TV show was filmed on the 40 acres back lot in Culver City, California. The set was destroyed in 1974, while the final scene of Isa, She-Wolf of the SS, was filmed. The theme music was composed by Jerry Fielding, who added lyrics to the theme for Hogan's Heroes, Seeing the Best of World War II, which you can hear playing in the background from an old record player. The episodes. The pilot episode, The Informer, filmed in early 1965, was aired on September 17th of that year. The episode's plot centered on two new prisoners entering Stalag 13. In this episode, was referred to as Camp 13. Lieutenant Carter, who escapes into the camp, and Wagner, who is actually a German spy posing as an Allied prisoner. Wagner attempts to expose Hogan's operation to General Buchholter, here known as Colonel Buchholter. But Hogan and his men are able to discredit the spy. As punishment for his outlandish claims, the spy is sent to the Russian front. The episodes. Although the series remained true to the pilot in most respects, there were some changes. Some of the prisoners' luxuries, such as the underground steam room, were eliminated to make the situation marginally more plausible. The character of Colonel Klink was made more of a fool than a villain. While his sharp accent was toned down, Klink's walk had less of a distinctive stoop. He also does not carry the riding crop he often affected during prisoner roll calls in other episodes. The major difference was that only the pilot was shot in black and white. After the series was sold to CBS, the network announced a major push in color programming for the 1965-66 season. And so the rest of the season and the series was all filmed in color. Student reviews. The first one is by Hezekiah Berry.
Hello, my name is Hezekiah Berry, also known as Kaya by my fellow students. Today, we'll be talking about Hogan's Heroes. I really like this show, and also my favorite part is when Hogan dressed up as a German officer, and all the Germans were like, hey, you had a German officer, and they were all fooled. I am amazed by how he solved so many problems in every episode. Thank you, and bye-bye!
And now for the student review of Charisma Berry.
Hi, I'm Charis Berry, also known as Charisma Berry by my fellow students. Today we'll be talking about Hogan's Heroes. Hogan's Heroes was really thought out and really funny too. Great comedy. That's why I like it. Now my favorite part of Hogan's Heroes is when Colonel Hogan dresses up as a SS officer, then goes through a bar and rallies up all the soldiers to make them do stuff. This is why I like Hogan's Heroes.
We love it! I asked my class, would you like to be Colonel Hogan? 80.6% said yes, and 19.4% said no. Any questions? So here, people would ask questions, and what we would do is we could click on any of these buttons, and we could go back and review the story, or the characters, the TV show, or any of the episodes. You can again look at the student reviews or look back at the student poll. Oh, I see, I have one question coming.
Mr. Berry, what was your favorite episode of Hogan's Heroes?
Hello, Sharon. My favorite episode has to be from Series 2, Episode number 20, Hogan and the Lady Doctor. I really like the writing in this episode because it shows there's a conflict. Headquarters tells them to bomb a certain place and Hogan says, no, I can't bomb, it's too risky. And there's a problem there that he has to work out. Plus, we get to see Ruta Lee. And I really like the cast in this episode. Oh, there's another question.
Mr. Berry, I have a question. How many episodes were in Hogan's Heroes? I really enjoyed that program.
Well, hello there, Elga. There were 168 episodes in all. One black and white, which was the pilot, and then 167 color episodes. Now, it ran for 6 years. Well, that was our presentation for Hogan's Heroes. Goodbye. Now, to begin the creation of your presentation, go to your Google Drive and then click on the blue button that says New and then down to Google Slides. And then Google Slides will load as seen here. So here we see the blank presentation. Now, not all of us are great designers and not all of us can make great themes. But one of the nice things that Google offers are these themes that we see here on this sidebar. And if you scroll down, you can see many wonderful designs and nice themes that were all created for you. Notice down here you can actually import a theme, and that would be if you had actually created a theme or if you found one on the internet. You can also create your own custom theme. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to find this theme called Slate and click it. I'm going to use that as my theme. Now we want to give it a title. So we'll click up here in the upper left-hand corner where it says Untitled Presentation. And we'll call this one Hogan's Heroes. One of the wonderful things about using Google Office, that is Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides, is that all of your documents and presentations are automatically saved right into your Google Drive the instant you make a change. So it's wonderful because you won't ever lose your work again. In case your computer goes down, don't worry, just log into your Google Drive on another computer and there's your presentation. And that's what it means by it saying all changes saved in Drive. Another thing you may notice is down here you have speaker notes. So let's type in some speaker notes. Hogan's Heroes ran from September 17th, 1965 to April 4th, 1971. And when you're doing the presentation, you'll see this on a separate screen with your notes, but the audience will see the main presentation. Now that we have our theme, we don't need this sidebar any longer, so we can just close it off by clicking on the X. And we can begin working and creating our presentation. So first off, we need to click here to add a title. So Hogan's Heroes. Now we're going to customize this to make everything stand out a little bit better. Now you can actually change your master template by going over here, clicking on Slide, and then going down to Edit Master. So what we're going to do is change the font that's being used on the master title style here. So I click it. Then I'm going to go up here to the font selection tool, go all the way down to where it says more fonts. That should always be the last option. And then to find the one that's similar to Hogan's Heroes font, I'm going to type in the word brush. And I'm going to use the Cabot brush here. I'll click it and you'll see a blue check mark and it'll also be highlighted in blue. Then click on OK. And you'll see that word now being posted in the font selection tool. Now, just to let you know, there are literally thousands and thousands of fonts in this area. So any font that you can ever think of trying to find can be found by simply clicking on more fonts. And the next thing we're going to do here is click on the B for bold. Now I'm going to reposition my main title. And I'm going to drag that to where I want it to be. You notice as you get to the edges, you'll see these red lines appear that tells you when you're lining up to an edge. And we'll drag that out. So I wanted the title there. I'm going to use this to the very top. So I'm going to move this to the top and then drag this one over. And I'm not using the three lines, so I'm going to click it and then hit the delete key once. Now I'm going to change my font size to size 60. Now once I'm happy with the changes I've done to the master slide here, I can go and just click on this X. And then I can go in and I can make my alterations to my title. There we go, that looks more like their logo. I can also drag this to be closer. I have more space for the picture that I'll be using. Now up here where it says add the subtitle, I'm just going to click there and type in presented by Daniel Berry. And notice I can make this a little bit smaller. So there we go, now it fits nicely. Now I don't like this gray background color here for this particular element. So I'm going to go over here to the fill tool, which is right here. I'm going to click it. And I'm going to choose light yellow. And then for my text, I'm going to go and change that to be this dark red berry. And if I want to make that more bold, I'll click on B for bold. There we go. Makes it easier to see. Now both of these text boxes that I have up here and here can have different alignments. But if I want both of them to be aligned to the middle so that they're centered here, since I have the first one already clicked, if I hold down the shift key and then click on the second box, now they are both highlighted and any change that I do will affect both boxes. So now I'm going to click on the alignment and click on middle. And you saw them move there, now they're in the middle of each of their text boxes. Now we have a number of elements already in our presentation. The next thing I want to do is insert an image. I don't want an image in this text box or in this text box, so I'm going to click here in the middle. And therefore none of the boxes are highlighted. To insert an image, simply go over here to where it says insert, and then down to image, and then across and down. And notice if you already have a picture on your computer, you can upload that image. You can search the web. You can go and look through your drive or your particular Google Photos, or by even the URL address of the photo. This time we're going to go and click on search the web. and this sidebar window should open. So in here you can click and then type in Hogan's Heroes and then hit the enter key once. So you notice there's many images of Hogan's Heroes here, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to find a special image on the internet for Hogan's Heroes. So I'm going to open up a new tab and I'm going to click on new tab here and then type in Hogan's Heroes, hit enter, and then go to images. And the image that I want to find is actually very similar to this one here, but it'll be the second one. So I'm going to click on that one, and that's what I want to use. Now to get that, I'm going to right click it, and then say copy image. Then after copying the image, I simply click back onto the tab that's holding my presentation. And I'm going to right click in the middle of this slide, and then say paste. Now I don't need these images up right now, so I'm going to click these off and I'm going to work with this image. So if I double click it, this allows me the cropping tools. These are the black lines that you see in the corners, and I'm going to very carefully crop off the area that I don't need. I can click away from the image now and the cropped off area disappears. Now I'm allowed to resize it and place it where I want it to go. So I'm going to move it down here. Once I drag the image right to the dead center of my slide, you should see this red cross appear in the middle of the image. You let go and now you know that it's evenly spaced in the center of your slide. Now notice how it covers up all of my text. So if I right click the image and then go down to order and then click on send to back. Next I'm going to click on the title Hogan's Heroes here and I'm going to change its color. So I could click on here where it says text color and I'm going to choose a light yellow. See how that looks. Now with this still highlighted, it can come up here to where it says the fill color. Right now it's transparent, but I can use my theme color. Now I may want to work more with that picture, so I'm going to bring it down a little bit. And let's see if I make it larger. Now if I want to add a line, a white line here between the picture and the title, all I have to do is click on line, click on the line, and then go over to where I want the line to begin, which is right here. Hold down the shift key and then drag it across. Now we have a thin line there. Now to make that line larger, just come up here to the line weight. And I want it to be 8, and I can change the line color clicking here, and let's choose this bright white. Now it shows a white line there, so if I click away, there we go. So that line really breaks up the picture from the logo here. So as you can see, we've started our presentation with a really nice cover page. So it says Hogan's Heroes in this really nice text or a nice font. There's some nice contrasting colors here. There's this white line here, have a really good background picture, and then it says presented by Daniel Berry. So far so good. Now let's say that I wanted to edit this picture a little bit more. I can actually click on that picture and up here where it says format options, click it, and I can adjust the color and other aspects of this picture. So I'm going to go down here and click on adjustments. And I'm going to increase the contrast and decrease the brightness just a little bit. Once you've made the adjustments to your picture to make it just the way you like it, you can click on close. We're now ready for the second slide. So to insert the second slide, simply go to Insert, then go down to the bottom where it says New Slide. Now you can use the shortcut Control M to do the same thing. There we go. Now I have this new slide. But I don't want to use this layout. So notice that we have these tools up here. If I choose Layout, the slide that I want to use is called Section, Title, and Description. So I'll click it once, and now I have the correct layout. So we have this slide here, but I don't want to have this gray background on this section. So I'm going to insert an image that covers this. I'm going to go Insert, Image, and then Search the Web. And the sidebar opens up. And then I'm going to click in the search and key in Hogan's Heroes. Then hit Enter. And the picture I want to use is this one here, so I'm going to click it and then click on Insert. Here appear in the middle of the slide, and I'm going to drag it over here to cover this half of the slide. And I'm going to resize it so it covers it a little bit better. Now once I have my picture over on that one side of my slide, I'm going to change my image a little bit. So I'm going to click on the image and notice that you have format options up here. So I'm going to click on format options. And here we have the recolor. I'm going to click on recolor and choose the very first one, which is called the light one here. And so now we have changed it. It's a little bit bluer. And I think it'll go better with my theme. Next, I'm going to take out the text that was here. So I'm going to right click on my image and say order, send to back. And we see these elements, and I don't want those elements. So I'm going to click on the subtitle, hit delete, and it goes away. And then I'm going to click on the add title and it becomes highlighted. And then I'm going to hit delete and it goes away too. I'm going to add a word art image here. So I'm going to go up here, click on Insert, and then down to WordArt. With this window, I'm going to key in the word Agenda. And then we're going to hit the Enter key once. And I'm going to change some elements in this WordArt. So first off, I'm going to go and change its font to match my theme. I'm going to choose the Cave brush. There we go. Now we have it in that brush style. And the next thing I want to do is change its color. So I go to fill color. I'm going to change it to light yellow 2. And then I'm going to change the border color, clicking it. And I'm going to choose the dark red berry 3. And now I get to move it over. And I'll resize it here a little bit. I'm going to put it exactly center of my image, so when I see that red cross, I know I'm exactly centered where I want to be, and I let go, and the image and the words look perfect there. Now my presentation had these boxes here, so let's add those now. So I'm going to click here and delete that bit out. And notice we have over here shapes. I need to find the nice rounded rectangle. So I'm going to click that. Now I can drag this over to create the size of the nice rounded rectangle that I need. And then I let go once I have the right size. Right now it's gray inside, but for my presentation, I want it to be dark green inside. So I'm going to choose the fill color here, click it, and I'm going to choose a dark green. For the text, I want it to be a yellow color, so I'm going to click here on the text color, and I'm going to choose light yellow number 2. And for the font, I'm going to go over here and choose the Cavett brush. And I want a larger font size too, so let's click on 14, and then I'm going to choose 24 and bold. And we'll click back into the box, and then type in the story. I'm going to click on the X here for the format options so I have more space to work with. And let's change the alignment to be centered. So I'm going to click right here on center, and that brings it to the nice Nice space there. Now, if I wanted the story words to be a little bit larger, I can go back and click here and change it. There we go, made it a little bit larger. There's several ways to increase the font size after you've already keyed it in. One is by highlighting it and then choosing the new size, like that. Or you can just simply click on this border and then do your change as well. I'm going to keep it at 30 there. Now, if I'm happy with this, then I go up to this blue border and right click right on that border and select copy, and then right click and go paste. So now I have two of these and I can drag it down here, and then I can say paste again and drag this one down. Now I can select all three of these by dragging this blue line all over them. And now all three of these are selected. And if I right click the top, go copy, and then paste, now I have all three of them done. Notice that red line there, that helps me align them up straight. There, now I have all six buttons. I can now select all of these six buttons here. So I can now change other properties. So if I right click here in the middle, notice I can go here and I can align horizontally, align vertically, even distribute evenly. So I'm going to go align to the center. So now all these are nicely spaced and I have a nice looking slide here with a good design. So now I can rename these by clicking into them and changing the text. So it was the story was first and then the characters. Okay, so I renamed these and I have a very good looking slide. Now we'll be ready for our next slide. So I'll go Control M. So here's the new slide, but I don't want this layout. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Layout and choose Title and Body. So now I'm going to click up here and title this The Story. And now I'm going to click and type in the story here. So here's the first paragraph. After keying in that first paragraph, then I hit the Enter key and I have the second paragraph here. Now after typing in the first part of the story, I'm going to be adding images as well. So I'll go over, click on Insert, Image, Search the Web, and I'll go with Hogan's Heroes. I'm going to choose this picture, and then resize it. So now I'm going to insert another image. I go Insert, Image, Search the Web, and again I'll go Hogan's Heroes. And I'll use this image here. Then I'll resize it and place it next to the first image. And it snaps right there when I see the red line. Now for my last image here, I want to find everyone there. So actually for the last image here, I'm going to find a image on the web. So I'm going to go New tab and then type in Hogan's Heroes and then go Images. There we go. That's the image I want. So I'll right click that one. Say copy image. I'll go back here and right click and paste. So now I'm going to resize it and put it next to my other images. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this slide. So I'm going to go and right click this slide and say copy. come down here and then click on and choose paste. So now I have two slides that are the same, but I can go in and change the text. And so I'm going to add more details to the story. And I'm going to change the shape of this by simply dragging this text box over. And then we'll take this photo here and resize it. I'm going to crop it a little bit here and resize it some more. There we go. So now I have two slides. One is the story, the first part, and then the second part of the story. Now a word about your text here. There's a great deal of text, and it's possible just to key it in or to copy it from a website such as Wikipedia or some other informative site that you find on Google. An easy way to do this is, let's say you did find the information at Wikipedia or someplace, you would highlight the text, and then you'd use the shortcut Control C to copy it, or if you wanted to, you could just simply right click it and then say copy there. And then once you get back into your presentation where you want that text to be, you then right click and then say paste. Now if you want to paste without any of the formatting from that other web page, such as the type of font that they used or the color of the font that they used, then you can use this paste without formatting shortcut, which is Control Shift V. Now I want to add a little side note about using images. Whenever you're using images from Google, you do want to check to make sure that if you are going to use it as a production, such as a commercial or something, you do want to make sure that there's no copyright on any of the images. And if you wanted to find other images to make your presentation really shine and stand out, you can use the website called Unsplash. At Unsplash, you can find free high-resolution images. Once you're at Unsplash, just click here and you can search for any type of photo. Once you find your images at Unsplash, just simply right-click, copy the image, and then paste it into your presentation. Now there's also Pixabay, which also has over 1.2 million images and videos which are shared, and they're free for you to use. Simply find an image that you want to use, right-click it, copy it, and paste it into your presentation or any of your work. So if I was to do a search in here, such as space, you can find many images of space. And if you wanted one, there's one there. You simply right click it and then say copy the image, and then you go to your presentation or any of your other work, right click and then say paste. Now going back to our presentation, I'm going to use the shortcut Control M to add a new slide. This time I'm going to change the layout to be title only. So I'm going to go over here to title only, click it. And this title is called The Characters. After keying in the characters, I'm going to be inserting an image. For the image, I'm going to go in and do a Google search for Hogan's Heroes and find a good picture of the characters. So here's a good picture here. Now this is the image I want to use, so I'm going to right click it and say copy image. Then I'm going to go back to my presentation, right click in the middle and select paste. I'm going to move this over and I'm going to crop the image a little bit here. And I'm going to click outside the image there, and all the cropped sections go away. Okay, I'm going to center my newly resized image here, and when I see the red line, I know I'm in the center. Now I'm going to insert some text boxes to point out the characters. So one way to do this is to actually click on insert and then choose a text box, or the easiest way for me is to click on the icon for a text box. And then I simply draw it out. From there, I'm going to change the font style to be the Covet brush. And then we're going to change the font size to 18. Let's choose bold. And then the color, let's choose light yellow number 2. And then I'll key in Colonel Klink. So notice up here I have shapes, and one of those is the arrows. So let's choose an arrow, click it, and then I'll draw the arrow where I want it to go. And let's position this a little bit better here. Now I can change the color of my arrow too by going up to the fill color. Let's choose light yellow 2. And the outline, let's choose black. Now once I have the text box for Colonel Klink exactly the way I want it, the text is perfect in there, I'm going to right click right on the border and select copy, and then right click again below my text and say paste. So now I have basically two text boxes that say the same thing. And I can move this one above Sergeant Schultz. Now I can highlight Colonel Klink and then type in Sergeant Schultz. Once I have his text box exactly the way I want it, I can click on the arrow and then use the shortcut Control C to copy it, and then the keyboard shortcut Control V to paste the arrow. And I can move this arrow exactly where I want it to be, so I want it moved here, and I can rotate it with this circle, this blue circle here, just drag it down, and then I can resize it and put it exactly where I want it to be. Now to get the text box for the rest of the characters, what I'm going to do is just go in and I'm going to right click the text box for Colonel Klink and say copy, and then right click and paste. I can move that where I want it to be. Let's have her text box have a background color of, let's say, this gray here. And then I'm going to key in her name. And what I might do is make this a little bit smaller to fit a little bit better. And let me change the alignment of her name there. So I go to Align, and then I want to place it in the middle. Put her name there. Now I'm going to paste the text box for labeling of Colonel Hogan. That one right up here. Now I'm going to paste the text box for Sergeant Carter. So I'll go right click, paste, and I'll move this right here. And I'll replace the text. Now I need to paste the text box for Sergeant Clinch. And then replace the text. After keying in the text, center the alignment here. There we go, that looks a little better for Clinch. Okay, now we need to label Corporal Newkirk. So again, we'll use a shortcut Control V and place his there. Wording here with his. Now we need to paste the text box for LeBeau. So we use a shortcut Control V. There we go. Let's move his label right there. And we'll replace the text. Now that we have the labels, we can now simply copy an arrow and then paste the arrows in. So I'll highlight the arrow here, use the shortcut Control C and then Control V to paste it. Use Control V again to paste the next arrow and rotate it around 180 degrees for that one. Use Control V again to paste the next arrow. Drag that one where I want it to be and then rotate that arrow. Resize it and place it right where I want it. That looks good. Control V again to paste the next arrow. And this will be for Carter. And then Control V again for Hogan himself. Okay, and I'll just copy the short arrow. Now this is looking pretty good here. I like this. Now with the labels and all these other elements for this slide completed, I'm now going to be wanting to group them together and form a special animation. So to do this, I'm going to click on Clink's text box, hold down the Shift key, and then click on the arrow. Now they're both highlighted. I'm going to go up to Arrange and then click on Group, and that ties these two together. So any animation that goes with one goes with the other. Then I'm going to click on Insert, Animation, and I'm going to cause it here, instead of fade in, I'm going to go in and say fly in from left. Now I'm going to do the same thing for Schultz. Click on his text box. Hold the Shift key, click on the arrow, click on Arrange, and then Group. Select Object to Animate. And this will be fly in from top. Then we're going to click on Hilga. Hold the Shift key, click on her arrow, click on Arrange, and then Group. And then click on Select Object to Animate. And instead of Fade In, I'm going to use Fly In from Top. Then for Hogan, click on Hogan there. Hold the Shift key down, click on his arrow, go Arrange, and then Group. And then select Object to Animate. And I'm going to choose Fly In from Top. And then for Carter, click on Carter, hold the Shift key down, click on his arrow, go to Arrange, and then Group. Select Object to Animate. And I'm going to have this fly in from top. For Kinch, click on him, hold the Shift key down, click on the arrow, go to Arrange, and then Group. Now they're grouped together. And then we're going to click on Select an Object to Animate. And I'm going to choose Fly In from Top. And then for Newkirk, click on that, and then hold the Shift key down, click on the arrow, click on Arrange and Group. And then we'll say Select Object to Animate, and this is going to be Fly In from the right. For LeBeau, I'm going to click on him, and then hold the Shift key down, click on the arrow, click on Arrange and Group, and then select an object to animate. And this will be fly in from right as well. Now to check to make sure everything is going well with this, I'm going to click on play. There's Clink, Schultz, Hilga, Hogan, Carter, Kinch, Newkirk, and LeBeau. So it's working very well. Now click on stop. So we're done with this slide here. So we go with the shortcut Control M to insert a new slide. We're going to change the layout again. So we click up here on layout and we'll choose the title and body. And this time I'm going to click up here and call it the TV show. So now I'm ready to add the text down here. After adding the text, I'm going to break this up a little bit here and separate these two by hitting enter. And then I'm going to highlight them and put them into what's called a bulleted list. So I click here. There's many options for the bulleted list. I'm going to just choose the first one. And now I'm going to resize this to about half the size. That looks nice. And now I'm going to find an image to place in here. So I'm going to go to my tab here with images of Hogan's Heroes. So I'm going to use this one here. So I'll click it. And then I'm going to right click it and say copy image. Then we'll go back to my Hogan Heroes presentation and right click and then say paste. Now what I want to do is let's add some nice animation to this. So I'm going to click on the paragraphs. I'm going to go down to insert and animation. And notice I have different paragraphs. So I can actually click on by paragraph. So what's going to happen is if I hit play, it's going to show the first paragraph and then the second one. So this is a very nice handy feature to use. Now we're ready to add the next slide. So I will Control M as a shortcut to add the new slide. And this is called the episodes. And there have been 168 episodes of Hogan's Heroes. Now let's add the text. So after adding the text for the episodes here, what we're going to do is we're going to right click this slide and then say copy and then right click down below it and say paste. And I'm going to add more information here to the episodes. So once we're here, we're going to click here and add the other text. So there you go. Now after you've added that text, I'm going to go down here and select copy and paste. And now I'm going to add the last text. Now after adding the last text here, then I'm going to resize this, move this over. So I need this space here for a movie, and it is easy to insert videos. So we're going to click on insert and then go down and click on video. We're going to key in Hogan's Heroes. And once you find one, we can click it and then click on select. Is it in there for us? Now I can resize this and I can actually do it full screen if I needed to. And if you wanted this to be full screen, you would drag it up to the corner. And then just simply drag it down here. But we won't need to do that. Now let's say if I wanted to look at the options for this video, I can right click on the video, go down to where it says video options here and click it. So I could change this. So if I wanted to start it at, let's say, 5 seconds into the song or into the video, I could do that. I can also end it at any time. I can change the autoplay when presenting, or I can even mute the audio if I needed to. And we'll leave ours at zero. Now I'm done with this slide here for the episodes. So I'm going to click inside there and use the shortcut Control M to insert a new slide. And I'm going to change the layout again to this one where it says section title and description. And this is the slide that says student review. Okay, now after keying in student review, we'll go over here and delete this text box. And this is where we're going to have our student review video here. So you need to create a student review if you wanted to do it just like this, and then upload it to your Google Drive. And to insert it in here, you click on Insert, and then go down to Video. Now, I'm going to go in and actually go into where it says Google Drive, because I know that's where I have some of my videos. But if you don't have that, then you would be able to actually insert videos from YouTube. So I'm going to choose Hezekiah's here, and then say Select. And then I will resize it. And I see I have room for another one here on the same slide, so I'll go Insert, Video, and I'll insert the second one there. So now you just simply resize it and position it and line it up to the first one. Okay, so now I have two reviews here. Now on the subtitle, I can click in there and put in their names. Hezekiah is the first one. And our second one is Charisma Berry. And since I have two reviews, I can add the word S on this. So it says student reviews now. Now in your particular presentation, if you don't have your own videos already, you can find them on YouTube by going to Insert, and then down to Video, and then you can do a search for YouTube, and you can do something like movie review or review of whatever item that you're doing, and then do a search and find other people's reviews. Once you get them, you would want to go over and right click on the video, go to Video Options, and you can actually change the starting point or the ending point. You can also do an autoplay when presenting, or even mute the audio. So now I can go in and change my text, format it the way I want it to be. So on the font, I can make it into the Cavett brush, and I can change the font color from white to light yellow number 2. Okay, now we're ready for a new slide, so I'll go Control M. Now I'm going to change my layout to big number here. These are really impact slides. They're meant to show information in a really easy format, and you don't have to read out all that information. The audience can see it and read it for themselves. So I'm going to click in here and type in We Love It, and then I'm going to drag this to the top. And we're going to add the poll here onto this slide as well. So we're going to ask the question, would you like to be Colonel Hogan? Resize this text box and then move it. Notice when I get my squares and my red lines there, it's centered. So there we go. And I'm going to put my chart right here. So I need to link my chart into this area here. So I've already created a Google chart with the information. So how do I put the chart in there? So you go to Insert, and then go down to Chart, and then From Sheets. And any of your spreadsheets that you've created in the past will appear here. Choose on the one that you need, and then click on Select. If you're happy with that chart, then click it, and then click on Import. Then you can move it to be just where you want it to be. Like that. Perfect. Now we're going to insert another slide. This will be the question slide. And what I'm going to do is scroll up here and find the agenda page. And then I'm going to click it. And I want this one to be repeated at the very end. So the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to right click it and then say copy. And then scroll down to the very bottom and then right click and paste. So this will no longer be my agenda page. This is now going to be my question page. So notice I can double click on this word art and then key in any questions. And I'll hit the enter key, and it's going to appear rather large. So I'm going to resize it. And if I want a different image here, I can actually click on this image. And right here it says replace image. I go down to search the web and find another Hogan's Heroes picture. And I'll click it. And now I'll click on the word replace found at the bottom. and it puts it down here. Now the next thing I want to do is have these buttons actually link to these pages here. That's very easy to do. Simply click on the blue border of one and then click on insert link. Then we have slides in this presentation. Choose that one and then go all the way down to the story. So you link the button called the story to the slide called the story. And then apply. And we'll do that for the next one now. Characters. And we'll choose that one and link it to the characters. Now we'll go to the TV show and link that one down to the TV show slide number 6. Then the episodes. And we'll scroll that one down to the episodes. Student review. Click on the link. Slides and presentation. Go all the way down to student reviews right there. And finally, we have the student poll. Click on link. And we'll go all the way down to We Love It. That was the student poll. Now that we have these buttons actually linking to these slides, what we're going to do is actually need to create a invisible button that we can click on here and take us back to the questions. So what I'm going to do is go up to the very top to the story here, and I'm going to go to the text box, and then we're going to drag and create a small box there. I need this box to be transparent, so I believe it is transparent there, but just to make sure, you can always click on the fill tool and click on transparent just in case it wasn't at first. Now we need to have this link to my last slide, so we'll make sure that we click right on that blue border and then click on insert link and then go all the way down to slide number 12 and then click on apply. What will happen now is every time I click this invisible corner, it will automatically go down to the questions. We need to put this invisible button on all of the slides though. So what I'll do is right click it and say copy, then go to the story number 2, go paste, and it pastes it there. Go up to the characters, paste it, now it pastes it there. Go up TV show, paste it there. Go to the episodes and paste it there. Go to the episodes number 2, paste it there. Go up to the episode 3 and paste it there. And then for student reviews, we can resize it so it's just in the very corner. So we pasted it there, and then in the poll page, I'll go over and paste it. So now we have it there. Okay, now that we have everything linked together here, we're going to create one more slide. This is the end slide that says goodbye. So I'm going to go Control M. On this last one, I'm going to change the layout. So I go to layout and then choose blank. So this one I'm actually going to be using are several pictures to create that animation. So I'm going to go in and actually find an image on the internet. And I'll use this one here, and I'll right click it, say copy the image, and then I'll go back to my presentation, then right click and paste, and then I'll resize it here to fill up the entire slide. Now I want them to be saying goodbye, so I'm going to go over here to shapes and click on callouts. And then I can drag it in And then I can place, I can pull this one where I want it to be. Then I click inside and I key in goodbye. Then we're going to change this font style here to the Cabot brush, and I'm going to make it much larger, and I'm going to center it. Might change it to this color here, and I can reposition it here. Now the next thing that I want to do is I want to appear as though he is saying this. So I'm going to have the call out box highlighted as we see here. And then we're going to go to insert and down to animation. And we'll notice I'm going to keep it as fade in, but this time I'm going to choose after previous. And let's click on play and see how that will appear. Oh, nice. So here we see Hogan, he's saying goodbye. So that is perfect. On this, I'm just going to make it a little bit slower so I can move it down here to the medium speed there. So this is a very nice ending. A couple other things to be aware of. We're going to need to have slide transitions. So if you look up here where it says slide, and then right now it says no transition, I'm going to click that. And we're going to choose cube and then go down and say apply to all slides. So we get it all done in one shot. So now we've created a really nice presentation. Other things that you might want to add would be perhaps speaker notes that you would add there by clicking down here. And anytime that you want to do a presentation there, you click on the first slide and then click on present. And it's working very well. There you go, that's looking nice. Let's see if these play.
Hello, my name.
Yes, that one works.
Hi, I'm.
And this one works. That's good. And to check to make sure these work here, there's the story. Click up here in the corner. There's the characters. And you can click on the corner there. Click on TV show. Click on the corner there. And then episodes, click on the corner, student reviews, click on the corner, and the student poll. So everything is working perfectly. Now another great tool that we have is if I click on this arrow, go down here, I have what's called presenter view. And here we can go with the audience tools, speaker notes would be there. And then I can go to any of the slides and see my notes that go along with that slide. If this was on automatic, I can pause it or reset. So there's actually many features that can be found in here. Now if I click on start new, so you'd actually be able to send questions and I'd be able to receive those and I'd be able to talk back over the internet. So that is your presenter view. Now you know how to make a presentation like a pro. If you're watching this on YouTube, please give it a thumbs up, share, and comment down below because I love to read your comments. Thank you again and bye-bye.